Alito, Chimachukma, this is Chief Steve coming at y'all with another one, another episode of True Story. Before we get into it, I want you guys to like this video and subscribe. We got 455 subscribers in the community, so I want to see 455 likes on this video, if that's not too much to ask, my Nijis. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get into it. Haluka. Alito Chimachukma, Chief Steve here. Today, we got another reaction for y'all. Now, we've been taught and we've been told by many others who don't look like us, particularly in the school systems, that so-called black people, who we now know as the reclassified and now declassified American Indians, have gotten their last names from slave owners, or they got their names off the plantations, based off of plantations. Well, I'm here to tell you guys, if you haven't known already, that that is completely false. We did not get our names off the plantations. If anything, the plantations were named after us, okay? Because as American Indians, we did own the majority of slaves in this country, in the mainland here in the United States. And those were in the form of indentured contracts. So I've got a video that's out there already that gets into all that. If you want to check that out, just go ahead and check out the American Indians Are Not African Slaves series. There's a whole lot of videos just on this alone. But I'm not going to hold y'all too long. We got another sister over here that has shared some valuable information about what we're talking about today. So we're going to go ahead and go to her clip. I found it here on X, and I hope you guys enjoy it. So without further ado, we're going to pause for the cause and we're going to get into that one. All right, y'all, we're here on X. Like I said, we got a lot of Nijis on here that give out some really good and valuable information, resources. So if you haven't already, make sure you follow me on next, because I'm usually sharing and reposting what's being shared and reposted on my timeline. So shout out to Indigenous King for reposting this from our sister Clout. I don't know if it's a sister or a brother. It looked like they have Shakari Richardson as their avatar. So I'm just going to go ahead and say, our Niji here, Clout, at Treason Season, if you want to follow them on X. But they posed the question, do black Americans have slave master last names? And we know that the black Americans are now the declassified American Indians. We have always been American Indians. Black was a thing given to us to have us taken from our identity, from our indigeneity, so that we can be labeled as slaves here in the future. But now that we know who the real slaves were and who the real slave master was, do we really have slave master last names? Not in the way that they tell us. A lot of our names are indigenous to here, because you don't hear a lot of people with names like ours anywhere else in the world. Everybody in different regions have certain names, certain families, and you can usually tell by the sound of the last name of where that person came from. But without further ado, like I said, we're gonna go ahead and get into this clip from this sister right here from TikTok, shared here on X.
So-called African Americans have always been told that we've gotten our last name from white tea slave owners, right? But see, the problem with that is that the white tea people who came to America through Ellis Island had names like Atomic, Adonis, Samaf, Benavamas, Virado, Capozillo, Cardino, Castro, Deshe, Puri, Hopman, Hausa, Hara, Haurisk, Janriska, Jazzback, Kroons, Cuplandy, Cats, Porskin, Raskin Skwask, Popolevaskask, Oskarnaski, Popo Velasquez, Persian, Roskinaskwisk. Them not our damn last names. Our last names be like Williams, Johnson, Smith, Jones, Brown, Jackson, Davis, Thomas, Harris, Robinson, Taylor, William, Wilson, Moore, White, Lewis, Walker, Green, Washington, Thomas. And the list goes on. You was not gonna see no Horoxus, bitch, on this list. You ain't never met no Tyrone Hawashkovich Brnaski. Stop playing.
Alrighty, y'all. So there you have it from our Niji. Just breaking it down for y'all about these different names here. And she ain't lying. And I mean, if this was the case, if we got our names from foreigners, and these foreigners were slave owners, wouldn't we have names like that? Nah, we don't have those names, right? So, and if you do have that name, and if you happen to be, hey, sometimes there's been some intermingling, there's been some admixtures, but you know, the blood is thick over here. You know what I'm saying? So, however you want to put it, if you need you, you need you. If you know, you know. All right. But this all comes down to, like I always say, family research. This goes beyond DNA, ancestry, genealogy, spit tests, science, pseudoscience. This is hardcore research that you need to do. Hard copy research. Get paperwork in your hands. Get birth certificates, get death certificates. You know, go to your hall of records. Look up your family's names and your libraries, you know, and really do the research. And if you have this name, these names in your family, then hey, ain't nothing against you. You know what I'm saying? Stand in your truth. But if you don't, and really take a look, because Ellis Islands has a registry. These different places where these different immigrants came into, they all have to register in a registry, right? So you can go to these registries and you can get these different names. You can pull up your ancestors if that's the case. But thing is, knowing who you are. Family research is key. And as you see, a lot of our names that we have today, particularly in the so-called Black community and the American Indian community, our names are indigenous to here. Our names have to align with parentage. They have to align with sometimes craft, sometimes environment or region, you know. We have land, we have names that are indigenous to this land. All right, so really do your research. And also, there's a good book out there, and I think I'm gonna share that a little later, or if I can, I'm gonna pull it up right now for y'all before I head out. I'm gonna pull this book up, and it has a list of last names that were actually tied to the so-called civilized tribes in this nation before the Act of the Dawes Rolls. Okay, so I'm gonna pull this book up for you, and y'all be sure to check this out. Give me 1 second. I'm gonna pause for the calls. Alrighty, y'all. This is the book right here. This is the Black America's Handbook for Survival Through the 21st Century. The Forgotten Truth Behind Racism in America. The Secret Heritage of America. Alright, and the author is Radine A. America. Alright, so this is a good book to have. I believe Brother Sosalinha, if you don't know who he is, check out his channel. Type in his name, Sosolinha. @Chimachukma_YT. You should find him pretty easy on here. Brother's been doing a lot of research and doing a lot of content on here for our Nijis, and I really appreciate him. But he went through this book and he shared some last names as well through it. But yeah, definitely check out this book. I got a copy here in my house for my kids, my family. And yeah, definitely get one for you guys. It's not that expensive. It's about maybe $40, no more than $40-something, you know, out the door. You can get that at Walmart. I believe it's Walmart. I saw a tag over there for Walmart, but I got mine from an actual bookstore online. And then I believe Amazon has it as well. I don't have any affiliate links, so I can't really throw that out there right now. But definitely look out for this book. You can screenshot this. If you have your mobile device, put it into Google, and it should pull right up. But yeah, definitely check out this book, man. It has a lot of last names that you would have never known were tied to Indigenous tribes. And you will see multiple last names that are tied into multiple different tribes, which should be just further affirmation and confirmation within your soul and within your lineage that, hey, I'm Indigenous here somewhere within this land, landmass. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, this is definitely an interesting topic. I think that the sister broke it down eloquently. And just to double down on what she said, they not like us. We not like them. We did not have those last names. Okay? Those last names are not ours. Our last names are our own. Okay? So stand in your truth. Stand on who you are. Stand on business. Okay? Remove the redactions. Remove the misnomers. We are not African slaves. We have an identity. All right, Black and African American are mentioned on the same line of the census, and they both serve the same purpose, and that is to erase us from our land, from our heritage, erase our identity from our indigeneity. Okay, so reclaim who you are. We are American Indian. Be proud of that. Stand on business. All right, so with that being said, this is Chief Steve signing off. If you was hanging with me this long, I truly appreciate y'all. Yokoki, I thank y'all so much for all the support. 455 strong in the community, and we're still rising. All right, make sure y'all like this video. Share this content with everybody that you know, and share the rest of the videos that you see on this channel and videos from other content creators who are spreading the truth. All right, and be sure to leave a comment. Let me know what you think about this. Okay. Once again, Chief Steve signing off. Tata Kista, I cherish y'all. And Yokoki, thank you. See y'all next time.